Hi guys, welcome back to another video. Today we're going to do some tattoo reactions again, but these ones are going to be ones that are like TikToks that will surprise you. Break up a little bit of doing the same ones over and over again, and maybe we'll see some new different ones. I'll give you my opinions as we see them. Let's get straight into it. We're back. Right, yeah, so as you can see on the screen, let's just go straight from this one. So there's a little bit of apple juice wiped away. That's sick. The only problem with like red tattoos, so to speak, is down the line they kind of look like scars. I've got one on my leg and it's the Pink Panther, and he, because the way it's done and there's no black lining that makes it so it stands out, you lose what it actually is. So now mine kind of looks like a scar. Same with that one. When that one heals over time, it'll have like a scar or it'll fall out. Or you won't notice it because the sunlight will hit it. More or less, they're really good for photos on the day. And then after that, they're not really worth it. Unless you're going to get some like black outline or black inside line. So I've got another one. Strawberry juice. See, that one's better because it'll actually stay. It's very micro. What are we on about here? I don't know. Okay. This shit doesn't make sense to me. I'll stick and poke. I understand that like, stick and poke's a thing nowadays. That is horrendous. That's sick. Stuff like that where they actually look like they're sewed in. Look amazing. Yeah, that's how he's cool as fuck. We'll talk about that one. That's clever. Yeah, that will take a lot of technical ability to actually get it to tattoo correctly. It's mostly to do with shading, to get it right. It's satisfying to watch someone actually tattoo. So even when you get into it, it's really satisfying. It's a good thing to take your mind off when you're actually dealing with the pain. To sit there and just mong out of the artist doing the work. Okay. As you can tell, this is someone else's video. always stressed, never blessed. That's clever. I rate that. These, like, I always see stuff like this all the time, whether like they're cutesy or simple. I suppose they make for a really good first tattoo because there's not a lot to do with it and you can kind of get the feel of everything. So shading, bold work, you can even have white in these. But a lot of the time they're very simple. Oh no, they're actually going for colour. Only bits, I'm guessing. Just like to add a bit of character to the design. As you can see, all the TikTok handles are there, so if you want to follow them, just click on their TikTok or go search them on TikTok and you'll see the actual designs that they do. Yeah, that's cool as fuck. I like that. Showing you guys tattoos. So if you guys want to see me do this, I'll happily do it. I have loads. Okay, so he's gone for the scatter of tattoos. Yeah, Margin Vegeta is sick. Mew. Yeah, I don't know if it actually says that though. Mew and Mewtwo. Now that is just loads of random designs. They look really cool, but I like structure to mine. That's a cool design. That's a really cool design. It's like they've lost the brain. Oh, that's off a cartoon. I used to watch it on Cartoon Network. Oh, what was it called? Dog and Cat? That's sick. Demon Slayer. So this is the kind of style I actually want to tattoo myself, is I want to tattoo anime. So this is going to be my main focus. So it's satisfying to watch someone actually tattoo it, because you learn a lot from watching, especially if you want to be a tattooist. It's a good thing to do, is watch a tattooist or watch them tattoo on YouTube, learn the techniques. Obviously drawing is one of the big ones, so make sure you consistently draw. And then it should all fall into place from there. Yeah, that's cool as well. The design's really nice. I wish they put the needles that they're actually using at the time. That's something if I do go further with tattooing, I'm going to be doing it all through YouTube. So I will be putting like needle sizes that I'm using at the present time, how long the tattoo took, what kind of tattoo it is, what kind of person that is having the tattoo, everything like that. I'll time lapse it. But yeah, that's cool. Okay, packing out for the colour. Clever. I love that like sharp Japanese writing at the top. It always stands out really well. And then it's just cross that shading. Yeah, and stipple. It's like the build up's always nice because you can kind of see the processes. Yeah, that's cool. I rate that. Me personally, I want to wait for the colour, but that's just me. A massive smiley face on their back. You're having a laugh. Such a good area to have tattooed. Like, I'm still deciding on mine, and I've got my full back. But why? If there's a reason. Jeez. That is grim. The work there has to be to have black is just so painful. See, that's sick. The color saturation on that is amazing. Oh wow. Okay, that's sick. That is very sick. The detail. It looks fake. Like when tattoos like that, obviously you can never tell if there's a filter, but it looks fake. Very, very, very good. Takes a lot of skill to be able to do something like that. His elbow must have been feeling that. Another one with really nice colour. Oh no, is that the same one? That was the same one. These are really cool. You open them up, like you get like a random tattoo from it. It'd be good for someone that like wants to get tattoos but doesn't know what they want tattooed. So you kind of go, cool, can I do that? Have a few little small ones. Geometry is really nice. That's what my tattooist does a lot of. He does that, but he's changing now, but stuff like that is really cool. Just like crazy geometry work. I've got some on my face and some on the back of my neck and my elbow. Oh, it's fucking, that's from Demon Slayer. Yeah. Sorry. I never understood why they put so much petroleum jelly on. Because, like, you don't need that much. You need, like, a fingertip. Never over cream your tattoos because you actually dry them out in the process. And they don't heal correctly. They actually have a negative effect on it instead. Is this what I think it is, where they like draw a really bad sketch but then the tattoo when they wipe it away is really good? Or is this just a really bad sketch? Why does that look like Snorlax? Yeah, fucking nut. No. Simple sketch turned into a really good tattoo. Color saturation is really good. What's this one? Ooh. Why black and grey though? I don't understand it. Because then if they add color, it's just going to be black and grey. The line works crisp. So hard to tattoo yourself as well. It's another thing that I've been trying to get into. Like, obviously there's always practicing on fake skin, but I'm trying to practice on myself as well. It's the hardest pain to go through because like your body's telling you how you're in pain, but then you're kind of like trying to tattoo yourself. It fucks with your head. Okay, that's cool. I love dark tattoos. It's really nice. These tattoos are like that. That makes sense. It's really cool. But you know when people have like the random stuff like John was here or something, it just doesn't make sense. I've never understood it really. Yeah, I like that. That's clever. It's a nice way to have an Antichrist symbol as well. I wanted that originally there, above my head, but my tattooist refused it. Don't blame him really. He kind of get judged for shit like that very easy. That's clever. I like that. Oh, is this all like little flashes? It looks like, oh, okay, it's a tattooing in the room. Oh, is this stick and poke? Wild. The fuck are we looking at? Oh, is it one of them where it's like they basically paint splatter on you and then that's what you get as a tattoo? It makes sense, but you're wasting so much like cool space just to have that, and most people have it black as well. What? Ouch. Putting yourself through that much pain just to have some random design just doesn't make sense to me. My mind's getting blacked out. But I wouldn't say that looks. It's just another way of doing a blackout, and it's just not nice. Go on. So there's an eye with circles. So the only problem I can see with it is it's far too small for the leg area. I feel like you could go a lot bigger. Especially with the amount of room, yeah. Definitely a lot bigger. It doesn't look big enough. It looks quite small for the size that it's in. Technical ability is sick because it's just dots. Takes a while. I'm guessing that's what they're doing for the lines. Is they're gonna dot all the lines? Then make some strong lines, and some of them will be stippled. Like, yeah, it looks nice, but now he's got so, that person's now got so much negative space. Oh God, 1 second. And we're back. But yeah, so that was the end of. I think this will be classed as like episode one because it's looking at good tattoos instead of looking at bad. 1 second, adverts. But yeah, so we're gonna do these every now and then, and they'll mix in with the bad. So then we can have like a couple of bad to one good, and then just kind of mix it up. But yeah, if you guys enjoyed it, make sure to like and subscribe. I will link the playlist to the bad ones. Top right or left, one of the two. But yeah, send me guys. Peace.